mi reorder, because apparently didn't like my... Hello guys, just a second. For some reason the OBS software decided to rescale my screen. Just give me a second.
Threw everything at the Bacardi family. The fire of 1880 couldn't stop us.
Second guys, for some reason my death monitor now it's a bit low guys, the sound.
Better?
Guys? Let me know if it's better the sound now. Hello guys. Exactly. Well, it depends on the baker. Baker, we can discuss about the dancing. Okay, now. Okay. So guys, let's be serious, eh, here. Let's get to business. It's not loud enough? Okay, just a second. Okay, nice. Let me know if now it's the mic is okay, guys. Hope it is. Hoot. Thank you guys. So let me close everything. Let's get down to business. Oh yeah. So what I'm gonna do today is the other day Candy Tree pointed something really useful that I planned to do for a long time. The other day I mean during the jam we did last weekend. So let me show you the code. Here, player input. Already started doing a little bit of it. Okay. Every update, the input manager will check if the player we are pressing right, left, up and down, firing, and things like that. Okay. So, and long time ago, like I don't know, a year ago or something like that, I decided to implement like a queue of states. So if the player was jumping, we will save in jumping on that queue. If the player was firing, this is actually can go out because we don't have shields anymore, or we cannot regenerate the shields anymore. Reverse, that is a new mechanic we implemented during the weekend, and so on. So. But of course, that means that here I check the the Witch Button. It's actually been pressed. And in the prior update class, we'll have to check again if that value is on the queue. So I'm actually checking twice the same value. So today I decided to, you see here, I was checking again all the values, if that state was in the queue or was doing some action. What I'm gonna do today is remove this behavior and add some delegate. So I will give the function I want the input manager. Hey Max! Okay, I hope the sound now is better. So what I'm gonna do is actually clean up a little bit the player update class, so we start having a better code. Also, if we have time at the end of the stream during the weekend, I implemented all this. Let me show you from here. All of this that you see here is what it makes the ship do the banking to one side and to the other when the player is moving, and also rotating and things like that. So I'm gonna remove this from here and put it in another class, because my plan for the next week or so is to clean up a lot the player classes, so we can add new effects and feedback for the user. Like when we switch the ship from looking down to looking up, do some kind of effect and things like that. And as you can see, the class is already like 570. So let's start doing that then. So first of all, in the player input class, I'm gonna create some new delegates. Delegate is just a new type, but instead of being a string, int, or anything else, it's just a function type. So if I create here something like on fire button, here I'm defining a new type, what is called on fire button, and here below I will create a new variable on my class from this new type I just created. I usually, what I do is use the same name plus DLG for delegate. So I actually know what when I'm calling a delegate, I actually know easily just looking at the code, but for that there is no good or bad. Okay, on fire button, which one was the other one? By the way, Max, that you're around, I implemented the God mode. So now if you press F12, you are in God mode, and if you press F12 again, you are normal. That's only for the developers, guys, sorry. And also for David, that he already requested that. So jump will be the other one. Oops. On jump button. A new backer, guys. They should be refreshed soon. Yeah, just F12, guys. F12, and you have God mode. And sometimes I will implement the I just did it a bit easier. F12 and you have Konami code will be a bit more difficult. So you guys want to debug something. Okay. Let's now call these functions on fire. So as I said, sorry. When instead of adding values to the queue, on fire button and on jump button, we'll be calling these functions. Okay. By the way, guys, just let me know how is Barcelona doing, my team. Sorry, Max. So I can concentrate on the stream. Okay, let's skip that up. Okay. So now, as you can see here, I have an initialization function. When I just receive as a parameter all these functions, let me on fire button and on jump button. Thank you, Kanye3. Or Miko. Let's concentrate on this. So, when I initialize the input. Ouch. Tomorrow we are still on time. If they treat tomorrow, that should be fine. Fire button. Much copy paste here, guys. So now I'm gonna have an error if I compile this. When I initialize my input on the prior update, I just will have to let me check on fire. Okay, on fire is already public, and the other one should be jump. Let's run it dips. long jump. Just to make to follow all the same names. So here, let's give those parameters. Player date. That should be on fire, and this one should be at jump. Was in public? This no, it's not public. Frame. Okay. Okay, now that this should compile properly. Okay. So let's try this, that everything we did didn't break anything. We still can shoot, or we still can jump. Couldn't stop us. Nor could the Cuban Revolution in the 1950s. Okay, and I still can turn around. Good. The Bacardi family didn't just survive, we thrived. Because true passion, all set to go. Good. Bacardi, untamable since 1862. So now we already spawn everything, so we won't be needing any more the state, if I'm not mistaken. Let me check that. Let me clean up a little bit this code. God mode, jump, fire. And the player movement, I will leave it for later, and that will be a little more complicated. So, our player smart controller, the post. Player input. Okay, the steps to process. The escape process is the last one. We need to decouple there. So, fire, swap weapon, there is no more jam. As I said, we created the. So, boss. Now it's gonna be a public method as well, and it will be called on pause. Okay. This. Okay. Where are we? How this got from here? Let's prepare already the initialize on the player input. Let's create a new delegate for the boss. Pause button. Well, YouTube will be there, hopefully. You never know, David. Okay, we have a new backer, actually. I think David is not doing his job properly. Back to programming. Now we'll have to assign this. Don't cry, David, don't cry. It's gonna be fine. Focus, David, focus. We need to reach at least 500 backers tonight. Eh? Tomorrow morning when I wake up, 500 backers there. Bam. On pause button. Thanks, continue. Continue. Sorry. Okay, now this will complain. Yep, just here. And we need to. Tonight. Exactly, that's the more 27k, but let's reach one step at a time, David. Inch by inch, till we're finished, remember? Just having a cup of tea, guys. Okay, let's try this, that everything works fine. I love those icons. Okay. Shoot, jump, reverse. Oh, pause is not working. Okay. because it's not working anymore. Why? Ah, because I'm not calling the delegate, actually. Pause button delegate. But I cannot put that on the stream, otherwise I think they're gonna mute it. I don't know, David, I can put Al Pacino inch by inch till we finish. 12 minutes, this is the biggest battle of our professional life. We're in shit, gentlemen. Shall I put it or not, David? Yeah, give me a second, guys. That's you're gonna only going to listen, but that's a video that David and myself listened a lot during this. No, I'm not saving the stream to my hard drive, David. It's 4 minutes. Let's go for it. So, guys, we want you to understand that during this Kickstarter campaign, we have listened to this speech like, I don't know, a million times at least, just to keep it going. So, here it goes. It's from the Any Given Sunday, the movie.
I don't know what to say, really. 3 minutes to the biggest battle of our professional lives. All comes down to today. Either
we here as a team.
As a team.
Are we gonna come?
We're gonna crumble.
As you can see, guys, I know the thing already. Play by play. Till we finish.
We're in hell right now, gentlemen. Believe me. And we can stay here, get the shit kicked out of us, or we can fight our way back into the light. We can climb out of hell.
Louder. Okay, guys, sorry.
1 inch at a time. Now, I can't do it for you. I'm too old. I look around, I see these young faces, and I think, I mean, I made every wrong choice a middle-aged man can make. I pissed away all my money.
Believe it or not.
Believe it or not.
Okay, pause is working again.
Anyone who's ever loved me. And lately, I can't even stand the face I see in a mirror.
Let me show you for a second.
You know, when you get old in life, things
can show you.
Get taken from. I mean, that's part of life. But you only learn that when you start losing stuff. You find out life's this game of inches. So is football.
So you can see here.
The game, life or football, the margin for error is so small. I mean, one half a step too late or too early.
We have all those.
One half second too slow,
at the moment.
Too fast, you don't quite catch it. The inches we
and the
need
inches are quite
everywhere around us.
Quite heavy.
They're
so I don't know. We have a lot.
Of the game, every minute, every second. On this team, we fight for that inch. On this team, we tear ourselves and everyone else around us to pieces for that inch.
Oh, yeah.
We claw with our fingernails for that inch. Because we know when we add up all those inches, that's gonna make the fucking difference between winning and losing.
Oh, yeah.
Between living and dying.
Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you this, in any fight, it's the guy who's willing to die who's gonna win that itch. And I know if I'm gonna have any life anymore,
is because I'm still willing to fight and die for that itch. Because that's what living is. The 6 inches in front of your face. Now I can't make you do it. You gotta look at the guy next to you. Look into his eyes.
Exactly.
Now I think you're gonna see a guy who will go that inch with you.
Hell yeah.
You're gonna see a guy who will sacrifice himself for this team because he knows when it comes down to it, you're gonna do the same for him. That's a team, gentlemen. And either we heal
as a team, or we will die as individuals. That's football, guys. That's all it is.
That's football, guys. That's all it is.
So.
Now. What are you gonna do?
Okay, after that inspirational speech, let's continue with the music. Let's go for it. So now, on the player update. As I mentioned before in the stream, for those that arrive later, during the game jam weekend or new feature jam weekend that David and myself did during the weekend, we implemented a new mechanic that is still ongoing. Let me show you what it is. Bye, Max. Thanks for dropping by. So this is the new mechanic. As you can see, now the ship, for some reason, is facing down. No more explanations there. But doing that, generated a lot of new code, because actually the banking is different where the ship is here than in the other side. Because when you're facing there and you click right, this is the side that's doing the banking. But when you are like, sorry, I cannot do it like this. When you click right, it's the other side, actually the one doing the banking. So that created a lot of mess on the banking code. Let me close out the code and I will show you. So actually what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna decouple all the actions for the player, like banking, jumping, firing and so on, in different classes, so I can centralize all the code there for those actions, and if we actually need to generate any effects, like when we're gonna re-reversing, we would like to do something like that with the ship and things like that. But first, let's start removing code from here. So, let's create a new, a new folder. Ah, the banking. Want to see the banking? Just give me a sec. Let me make this a bit bigger. Maximize on play, yeah. You see the ship, it's actually banking. I don't know if the French will allow you to do that, but and when you are looking facing down, let's say the left side is on the right side and so on, so when you go left, the banking is in the way around. That actually created a lot of problems during the weekend. And facing up again. So, the first class, I want to decouple is the rotating one. So, scripts. B- By the way, we are programming in Unity and C Sharp. Player, let's create a new folder here. I will call it player actions. So all the jumping, rotating, firing, and so on will be here in different classes. Because otherwise, this folder, as you can see, already start to grow. Well, that's a question for David. We're gonna stay up for the next 24 hours, David? I mean, let's go for it. Okay, Visual Studio now. Let me regenerate the files. Sometimes it takes for a while till it refreshes everything that I create in Unity on Visual Studio. And if an empty folder, this will get some problems there. But player rotation. Now should be okay. Yeah. Well, I think both will get fired. What is Visual Studio? Here we are. Open for me this class, reload. Here we have our own GameObject class. Something that I program in another project. All the event system, XML reading and writing, and so on. It's in a different project. Only code. It's a DLL. But that will be reusing all further projects. Actually, I don't know why I don't need this. It's a normal class. Let's go 24 hours streaming, David. Okay. Barca will play the Champions League final. So not 24 hours streaming, David? What I'm looking for here is... Now I completely lost track. What I was going to do right here. So, play it. All this. For Trent, I will say everything has helped. Or secret, the secret weapon, or what? Yeah, David, show the full meme. Yes. So now it's in the correct place. data is the only information I'm missing in this class, looks like. So this class actually what it does is it checks if you are moving left or right and what is the current rotation. Depending on that we'll do the banking left facing up, banking right facing up, banking right facing down and banking left facing down. As the effects are a little bit different, I just create a different method for all of them. But I need player data here, so let's create a constructor for like player rotation. Let's create a local copy of player data. Let's force the constructor to receive the player data dev reference. And we store it locally. Here we are. I don't need to listen to the music. Just you can hear me, guys. So sorry, I had an error. There is no more ship rotation. And player update. Okay. There is no more update. That's a good point. So David, how is the green light going? Are we green lighted already or not? Copy paste there that yeah, for Candy 3 we are actually quite new to all of these videos and streaming and so on. I think you can see here in the description of the channel that from now on, Tuesdays at that time, I will be streaming. Thursdays, David will be streaming, and Saturdays probably will be doing parties, like playing games or playing our own game or thing like that. Welcome back, Hobbs. And what to do if we fail? We'll see when that happens. I don't know. We have different ideas, so we'll see that. Okay. Private player update. No, sorry. Thank you. de The Rotation. Good. Exactly. Focus on now, and not on later, guys. Okay, sorry. Got distracted again. So in the prior date class, I'm going to centralize all the más que prior date. I don't like it anymore here. Let me see what I did here in the past. Respawn and initialization. No, it's going to be in the prior control class. Yeah. So here I'm going to create all the control update control classes prior. Rotation. Actually, I'm gonna call change the name of this control. So rotation control, and here in the awake. We just initially set new player data. So here we do rotation control dot update rotation. That should be good enough. Whoa. What the fuck? I cannot agree more. What happened there, David? What happened there? So. Whoa. Yeah, I got the email now. Well, it's not a new bucket, David, but we can update the name, right? I do it. Oh, yeah. Thank you, man. You will be the next one on the last backer box, and that should be compiling already. Yeah. Let's see if the ship is still banking. Should be. We didn't change much. And thank you, Trent. And thank you, Eric. By the way. Banking still there, so not that bad. So next thing, I'm gonna remove from that prior date nasty class. All the actions are gonna be here, so this won't compile anymore because we don't. It's on this class already. Good. Okay, prior update. en reverse. Let me reply to that one. I have had the perfect picture for that, David. That's exactly what she needs to say. An image is better than words. Okay, let's decouple this on in on reverse action. Okay. Don't go away. Don't go away. Player. How was this called? By the way. Reversed. Player. Reverse. Action. Well, that's all here, so no. Let's call it. Light. Explain you guys in a short while how this is working. Player reverse. Let me create the constructor. Ouch. Data is the only thing I will need. I will explain you what we do here, guys, in a short while. Just let me receive the. First of all, let me remove the control from the name. I don't like it anymore. It's an action. I will have to make this available somewhere. Okay guys, what we do here is we have a small cooldown for this effect. So you only can reverse the ship after so while. Let me private account. Float reverse cooldown equals later in time I will remove this to a configuration file, but for the time being, if David just in case wants to tweak it, I just put it like this. So if the cooldown is already gone, or it's the first time, we just will check which is the position of the ship and rotate the instead of that, let's make things properly. Private reverse steps facing up reversing down facing down reversing up. Not right now, because right now the effect is just automatically, but in the future we would like to do some kind of effect while the ship is reversing. So I create already the steps. Any new backers? David, I take care of it. Don't do anything. You do it. Okay. David, I take care of updating the new ones. Because we have like 3 new ones. I will slowly put them. So everyone gets its moment of glory. Jokes apart, Sterling, Trent. Thank you, man. You are awesome. Let's continue this. Steps, reverse state. Okay. The original reverse state will be facing up. Name of my dog. I don't have a dog. Not yet. Actually. Facing up. Okay. Exactly. That's what I told you. I will control the. I will put all of them slowly, so everyone stays there for a while. So we decide to remove this nasty thing if reverse state. So if we are facing down. We are facing up, actually, and for the time being, we will change equals stairs facing down. Later on, I will program this properly, so which music are we not listening? Yeah, it's really calm, David, but we need to be more like. We like the rocking. Sorry, guys. Let's keep this more serious. What I was thinking is... Okay, and here what I do, it's I created a small piece of code to create timers, actually. And when the timer is done, we'll call this function, what is on reverse ready. So next time, we'll be able to do this again. But yeah, it's a really good playlist. I didn't put my headphones because it's I sweat a lot when I talk and program and all at the same time. We are in the Netherlands, but even though it's a bit warm these days, summer is here. Okay. So facing up, facing down, and here I have to put it facing. For those interested, what we do is actually I just rotate the model 360 degrees. I change the camera scroll speed and I disable the thruster effect. Actually, when this class is more, let's say, close to finish, all this shall be captured in a local variable, so I don't have to be calling all this blah blah dot priorship mesh dot find child dot, but for the time being it's good enough. Actually, I will need that. Let's capture already the transform thruster. Let's capture this at the beginning so I don't have to look into the tiles all the time, because this is really not a good performance wise to keep doing this all the time. And let's now, you can see when you go for a game jam mode, sometimes the code you do is not the best, and that's being nice with myself. So I need to change the backer debit because they keep coming, and we will sorry Trent, what's going on? Now Rachel it is. So thank you Rachel. Another one. And still two more to go to put on the list. Okay, that should be a bit more clear, guys. Compile should be an error. Yeah, I know. That's why I already changed Trent Sterling, sorry. But now Rachel is the famous person in house. Rachel is the queen in the house. Okay. It's ready, it's not used here anymore. Oh yeah, we got more. Oh yeah. Player doesn't die. What is this? Oh yeah. I lost what I was going to. Ah, see, on reverse. We decided that ensenyar. Reverse control. Let's initialize this. This reverse dot reverse. Okay, hopefully that it should do the trick, so we should be reversing again. Let's try that. So, player update. What else do we need to... Oh man, this is so bad. Okay, let me check this code. The camera a little bit not straight. Sorry guys. So Michael Zimmer Zimmer. Thank you man. Say hello if you are in the stream right now, just in case. We'd love to hear from you. Oh man. Hit a little bit there. By the way, Mike Zimmer wasn't sure, but he likes our demo. So, good job, guys. Good job, team. Demo was good. Let's continue. That is a little bit more tricky, as you can see. By the way, David, shall we remove the jump waiting? Cool down. Oh man, I have so many things to do. Yeah, that's I say that, David, I say that. You're not listening. That's why we put an alpha version, early alpha version of the demo there, right? So people come back us. So let's create a new action, as we were creating today, guys. Let's call it player jump. Sorry, I also have the email open. Michael is the next backer. Sorry, Michael. Ah, who is Michael? Michael is the last backer. we don't know who is Michael, Michelle, I don't know how to properly pronounce it. You took it, what? To be low enough? I don't like it, David. It's too much. Anyway, you're the game designer. We'll fire you and hire another one. Don't worry. If you want to keep it like that. Player jam, there is not a mono behavior here. Okay, player date on jam. This is gonna be tricky. Okay. Yeah, our system, unfortunately, Candy, our system is a little bit manual. We didn't got the time, so we already had a lot of problems to make the OBS software work properly. Alaikum salam. Good night, everyone. Okay. This. As usual, we need the player data, margin here and there. Yes, the jam class. This one is going to be fun. Using TI engine. TI engine is our own TI for Too Awesome. Yeah, we have that original. We have some classes there that encapsulate like our event system and timers, I don't know, XML management. So, hello everyone, joining the chat. We are trying to program today a little bit. Okay, this is definitely okay. But having a copy of this class everywhere, I'm not so sure for the time being. But I also don't like to have like gamecore.instance.playerdata.blah blah all the time. So I will have to think in a proper way to have a player data singleton. But not today. Not today. So all these classes can remove the accessing and copying back and forth. Yeah, we're having fun. We had a big player at day class with already 600 or more lines, and a lot of effects missing, like when you are jumping or like reversing the ship or banking or things like that. So I'm trying to decouple all of this in different classes. By the way, guys, I'm a bit thirsty. I have been like an hour and a half already live. I will stop for like about 3-4 minutes, and so I have something to drink, and I will come back if you don't mind. Just 3-4 minutes. And by the way, before I go, thank you, Mikhail Masmachev. I hope I said that right. Thank you, man. 5 minutes. Let's call it 5 minutes, and I'll be right back.
fate through everything at the Bacardi family.
Sorry guys, I forgot to put the mic on. 1980 couldn't stop us. My bad. Nor could the Cuban Revolution in the night. So, as I was saying, I'm trying to decouple the flight control glass into small pieces. I'm also cleaning up this glass because it's really, really old. Yeah, I already fixed that, the sound problem. Sorry, guys. Okay. These cooldowns are killing me. David, because I think you did that. Why we have a fire cooldown and a jump warm up? I don't get it. If you remember why, just let me know. Otherwise, I will change as I please. Change it as I please. This is the jam. A fire cooldown. Sorry. Didn't say anything, David. They didn't say anything. It's getting late, you know. Has been a really exhausting month. To make it everything more clear, let's create an enum with the different states. Private enum jump states. Let's move what we want ready, and I want to cool it down. And a new bar. Jump state, jump state, and of course when we start we are gonna be ready to jump. Oh guys, you are really going on delay, eh? I said that like, I don't know, 3 minutes ago. The cooldown on fire thing. Okay, the player pushes jump. Okay, I will have to come back to that later. Okay. I hate this so much. Instant shitting defect all the time. I'm dying here, David. I'm dying here. This is actually checking for the margins of the screen. Because what we do is we basically split the screen in two sides and half for the left, half for the right, as you can see. And we apply some margin, 3%, but it's not that much, so the player doesn't go out of the screen at any time. How many times I heard the Bacardi family ad. It's a good ad, David, but when you listen to it over and over and over and over. My level data. want to do is to call this as soon as the jam cooldown is finished. My level data, what is coming from my level data? Never surrender mode. Okay, next time it's it goes. Oops. I will listen to it. Okay. Okay. Yeah, that's the problem of. Basically what I'm saying is create a new coroutine, and when it finish, call this function and make the jump ready again. Can't be tamed. What is that? Margins, change the heat. Press the event, start the timer, that should be all we have to do. Right. Compile this. What's the error? Let's go with this. What's the error time? Ah, sorry. Instantiate this new class we are creating, larger jam, jam control, jam control, larger jam, player data. It's not about the micro, David. It's about the. I'm speaking for myself. Really, really low. Jump control. On jump. Okay. Hopefully. weapon cooldown. This doesn't exist anymore. I hope you can hear me now better, guys. Let's speak it a bit louder. What I was thinking now is to try this. Let's see if we jump again. So we can shoot and oh yeah, and I jump somewhere. So I actually broke it. Nice. When you break the code, it's nice. Yeah, I think I'm gonna call it for the day, like in 10 minutes or so, like at 12. That will make a couple of hours of streaming. Good for today. So, why this is jumping wrong? I do instantiate with the player data, Try now. Mm-hmm. put this in the maximum display. Maybe the cameras are getting a bit crazy. No. Why? When I hear I'm fine. Well, this is a feature, David. No, it's not a feature. You cannot avoid the rocks. But actually, where is it? The player. What is... It's like outside. Okay, why is jumping here now? Come on. This is ready. Yeah. If we put a breakpoint and see what is going on here. Actually fine. Game object, blah blah blah. It's not left acted. X margin, screen width, blah blah blah. Some min pause. This code is actually wrong. Why don't you want to jump? Okay. is left active. No reference, there's no point of doing that. Good night, José. Trying to understand why, when I decouple this this class, it's not working anymore. What is a good question? A bit late. A bit late here in Europe, so I'm getting tired now. The margin.